These are the prayers of God's people. Lord Jesus, you reached out to us, so many different people with so many different needs in so many different situations. We thank you for the ways you have reached out to us in the embrace of prayer, in the energy of a song, in thought sparked by a sermon, and in the wisdom of a word from Scripture or the words of a friend. Sometimes your healing has brought comfort. Sometimes it has brought challenge and the call to respond. Hear us as we seek your comfort and your challenge for the world, for the church, and for our lives. Bring comfort to those whose lives have been overturned by the pandemic, to those whose work or study has become so much more difficult, to those who cannot find work and don't know where to turn, to those who still struggle with COVID-19 or another lingering illness, and those who have lost hope that things will ever improve. Bring challenge to those who lead recovery efforts over the next months, to those whose decisions affect the well-being of the vulnerable, to those who guide economic and educational planning, and those who are rebuilding community life. May your wisdom and compassion guide them. Lord Jesus, bring comfort to those who are lonely or shut in, and to all who have lost beloved family members or friends during the pandemic. Bring comfort to those who feel pain without relief, and those who wait for diagnosis or life-restoring treatment. Offer peace to those who know there is no treatment, and wait in hope for your eternal welcome. Bring challenge to those who want to make the world a better place, and to all who work with science, medicine, and the law to improve the quality of life for all people. Give them a vision of their work that is both just and courageous, so that no part of society is neglected or mistreated. Challenge those who stir up violence and unrest with a sense of shame for the cost to innocent lives, and with a deeper understanding of what justice means. Lord Jesus, comfort your church in places where ministries struggle, whatever the reason. And challenge your church to renew our vision by ministry so that our witness is faithful to your all-embracing love, expressed not only in words but also in the actions we take to embrace those who differ from us and yet have a place in your heart and your eternal care. Hear us now, as we pray in the words you taught us, Lord Jesus, as we sing. Closing hymn, sent forth by God's blessing, Voices United, 481.